Thank you. come this morning to say farewell to a departed brother and to commit him in the hands of his vicar, the God who made him for himself. And so, today, with faith in Jesus Christ, receive the body of our brother Edward for burial.
Our brother was washed in holy baptism and anointed with the Holy Spirit. Let us therefore with confidence pray to God our Heavenly Father, the giver of life, that he will raise Edward to perfection in the company of the saints. The Lord be with you. Let us pray. O God of grace and glory, remember before you this day our brother Edward. We thank you for giving him to us, his family and friends, to know and to love as a companion on our earthly pilgrimage. In your boundless compassion, console all who mourn. Give us faith to see in death the gate of eternal life, so that in quiet confidence we may continue our course on earth until by your call we are reunited with Edward and all those who have gone before, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Jesus said, I am the resurrection and I am the life. He who believes in me, though he died, yet shall he live. And whoever lives and believes in me shall never die. Jesus said, let not your hearts be troubled. Believe in God, believe also in me. If we live to the Lord, and if we die to the Lord. So then whether we live or whether we die, we are the Lord. For this and Christ died and live again, that he might be Lord both of the dead and of the living. We brought nothing into the world, and we take nothing out. The Lord gives, and the Lord takes away. Blessed be the name of the Lord.
We, at this point, will ask everyone to sit and invite the person or persons doing the tributes to come forward.
Hi, good morning, everyone. Before I even start, you know, it's like a dad to me, like from day one. So, like, for me, today is very tough. So, bear with me. Okay. Today, we gather to honor the life and legacy of Edward Neil Yeates, a man whose impact on the world will forever be remembered. Born in Belmont on September 23rd, 1939. Edward's journey through life was marked by dedication, passion, and a relentless pursuit of excellence. From his early education at the Eastern Boys Primary and Belmont Boys Intermediate, where he excelled academically, to his pursuit of higher learning at the Wilsden Technical College in London and the University of Wisconsin in Milwaukee. Edward's thirst for knowledge and growth knew no bounds. His achievement in the field of civil engineering, culminating a master's degree, stand as a testament to his hard work and commitment to his craft. Throughout his distinguished career, Edward served his country with honor and distinction. First, as a civil engineer in the Ministry of Works, then as the Director of Drainage, and later as the Permanent Secretary of the local government. His expertise and leadership led an indelible mark on the infrastructure of Trinidad and Tobago. Edward's professional journey took him even further, earning his PE license and working as a New York City transit consultant before retiring. His contributions to the field of engineering will continue to inspire future generations. Beyond his professional accomplishments, Edward was a loving father, a devoted husband, a brother, an uncle, a grandfather, a father-in-law, a brother-in-law, and a cherished friend. His kindness, wisdom, and sense of humor touched the lives of all who had the privilege of knowing him. As we bid farewell to Edward Neil Yeates, let us remember him not with sorrow, but with gratitude for the time we shared, the lessons imparted, and the memories that will forever live in our hearts. May his spirit continue to guide us, and may his legacy inspire to survive for excellence in all that we do. Rest in peace, Edward. Your light will shine forever.
Anybody else?
So we will now stand for opening hymn, which is printed on the funeral bulletin, "Because He Lives." God sent His Son.
God sent his Son, they call him Jesus. He came to love, heal and forgive. He lived and died to buy my pardon, an empty grave is yet to move. My Savior lives, because he lives, I can face tomorrow, because he lives, all fear is gone, because I know he holds a future. And life is worth living just because he lives. How sweet to hold a newborn baby and feel the pride and joy he gives. But greater still, the calm assurance. this shark can face on certain days, because he lives, because he lives, I can face tomorrow, because he lives. All fear is gone, because I know he holds a future, and life is worth living just because he lived. And then one day I'll cross the river, I'll fight like fine, I'll war with pain. And then as death gives way to victory, I see the light of glory, and I know he lives. Because he lives, I can face tomorrow. Because he lives, all fear is gone. Because I know he holds a future, and life is worth living just because he lives. And life is worth living just because he fear is gone, because I know he holds a future, and life is worth living just because he lives. Let
us pray. Almighty God, we remember before you today your servant Edward. And we pray that having opened to him the gates of larger life, you will receive him more and more into your joyful service, that with all who have served you in the past, Edward may share in the eternal victory of Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. Let us sit as we now open our hearts to the reading and understanding of the Word of God. So we invite the first reader.
First reading is taken from the book of Isaiah, chapter 61, verses 1 to 3. The Spirit of the Lord is upon me, because the Lord has anointed me. He has sent me to bring good news to the oppressed, to bind up the brokenhearted, to proclaim liberty to the captives and release to the prisoners, to proclaim the year of the Lord's favor and the God of vengeance of our God, to comfort all who mourn, to provide for those who mourn in Zion, to give them a garland instead of ashes, the oil of gladness instead of mourning, the mantle of praise instead of a faint spirit. They will be called oaks of righteousness, the planting of the Lord to display his glory. They shall build up the ancient ruins. They shall rise up the former devastations. They shall repair the ruined cities, the devastations of many generations.
The end of the reading.
This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. psalm is Psalm 23.
The Lord's my shepherd.
Reading from Revelation 20, 22, lines 2 to till 8. I saw the holy city, the new Jerusalem, coming down out of heaven from God, prepared as a bride beautifully dressed for her husband. And I heard a loud voice from the throne saying, "Look, God's dwelling is now among the people, and he will dwell with them. They will be his people, and God himself will be with them and be their God. He will wipe every tear from their eyes. There will be no more death or mourning or crying or pain, for the old order of things has passed away." He who was seated on the throne said, "I am making everything new." Then he said, "Write this down, for these words are trustworthy and true." He said to me, "It is done. I am the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end. To the thirsty, I will give water without cost from the spring of the water of life. Those who are victorious will inherit all this, and I will be their God, and they will be my children.
The hymn, "It Is Well With My Soul."
Yeah.
The Lord be with you. Reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Jesus continued, "Do not store up for yourselves treasures on earth, where moth and rust consume, and where thieves break in and steal. But store up for yourselves treasures in heaven, where neither moth nor rust consumes, and where thieves do not break in and steal. For where your treasure is, there your heart will be also." This is the gospel of Christ. Praise to Christ, our Lord. May the words of my lips and the meditations of all our hearts be acceptable in your sight, O Lord, our strength and our Redeemer. Amen. Please sit, everybody. Let me begin this morning by expressing on my own behalf and on behalf of the wider family of St. Mary, St. Mary's Parish, our deepest condolences to the family, close relatives, wife, children, and other close relatives. Our deepest sympathy we share this morning. Even as we participate in this funeral, we share our sorrow, the sadness of the family at this time. And of course, sadness is, there's nothing wrong with being sad. There's good reason for sadness. A loved one, much appreciated by everyone, a loved one departs, and those bonds are broken, and those bonds of love are broken. We wouldn't see this person at least for a while again. And that sense of loss is naturally what we feel, the sadness that accompanies it. There is, you need to have no feel anyway strange or unfaithful or anything like that, because we are sad. And God is in the midst of it. We remember Jesus himself. In the case of his very good friend Lazarus, of course he raised Lazarus again, which speaks to us for the future. But when there was all the sadness of family and friends, Jesus, in the midst of it all, identified with it all. And in that shortest verse in the Bible, it tells us, Jesus wept. Jesus felt that sense of loss and sadness. Of course, Lazarus was also his very good friend. Jesus then empathized, and I say empathizes, I dare say, with us this morning in our own sorrow. Having said all of that, as Christians, as believers, we are called, yes, to mourn, but do not mourn as those without hope. And we have a hope. A hope that is our consolation. And at the very beginning of our service, we expressed that hope as we received the body. Yes, we acknowledge that he had gone ahead of us. We acknowledge that death has been conquered. That we need have no fear, not fear why we are sad. We are sad because we lost a loved one. But death has been conquered. Death has been made to serve. Death has become for us the gate to eternal life. That holds no terrors for us. It opens up for us that new life. And that's our hope. That new life which God has promised to those who believe, the faithful, those who live the way that his Son taught us to live. You see, God made us all for himself. He made Edward for himself. You and I, all of us, he made us for himself. He wants us. And he organized things in such a way that there'll be a time, the time will come when we will all be united together with our God. Sin, of course, came into the world. It started with Adam and Eve. That plan that God had for you and I and all his creation was from the beginning. But alas, Adam and Eve, you know, were tempted and led astray. And God had this plan, this long-range plan of saving humankind, because God couldn't countenance eternal separation from his creation. So God's plan of salvation worked its way through, and we can follow it in the Old Testament right up to the coming of Jesus. God called Abraham, we could start there if we wish, and promised to make him the father of a people, great people. Yes, look at all the time past. The Israelites, Abraham's descendants, were in Egypt under slavery. God set them free under Moses to lead them out into that land where he will be with them and where they will worship him as their God. God was working his plan of salvation out. Of course, the people were not always faithful. They turned away from time to time, and they were punished, and God forgave, and they came back again. God's plan continued in twists and turns, we might say, as we follow the story. God always planned to send a redeemer, Abraham's descendant. So long range God's plan is Abraham's descendant. That was Abraham's purpose. That the whole world, not just Jews, will be saved. And Jesus came to the world. The Jews thought he was theirs, but he came to save the world, all of humankind. All who would believe. It was not a matter of blood anymore. It was a matter of faith. God sent his Son. And those of us who were in church on yesterday would have listened to that epistle from Paul where he spoke about Jesus, who was God, but did not want to cling to equality with God in the light of what he was called to do. He was prepared to give up his divinity, if you want, put it aside, as it were, so that he might take on human form. One who was to save us must be one free from all sin. He was the one. Free from all sin, that he might take upon himself the sin of the world. And therefore, through him, all those who believe will have their sins forgiven once they confess and repent, and therefore have eternal life. So eternal life is God's gift for each and every one of us, for Edward and for us who are continuing this journey on earth. What does that mean for us? It means that we hold on to that hope for our brother. All who believe will have eternal life. Jesus said, I go to his disciples, those who believed and followed him, that I am going to prepare a place for you. And so that place is prepared for those and ready, although not yet read in Revelation, but 21st chapter, time will come when God will establish his kingdom. Heaven and earth will be brought back together, a new heaven and a new earth. God's people will all be gathered. God will be in the midst of us all. Meantime, we live in faith. Faith in Jesus Christ, the one who came. God sent his son. We sang it just a while ago. God sent his son. That's the extent of God's love for us. We have a part to play. That part is an assent. Assent. Believe that this is so. Believe that God has made it so. Believe that indeed we were made for God and we were really made for eternity. We must die the death of this natural life. And when the time comes, raised again as Christ was raised to that new life in the new heaven and the new earth that God himself will reign over. And that is our hope. How do we live it out now? Faith. Our passage here, a short passage from the Gospel of Matthew, tells us that our focus cannot be exclusively on the things, the temporary, transient things of this world. Our hope must be a hope for the future, a greater hope. Our store must be on a greater hope, not on things that will pass away. All these things, fame and glory and money and property and all these things, I'm not trying to say they are evil, but they must be placed in their proper context. They're secondary because there's our primary goal to be among God's people. Because of our faithfulness, our faith in Christ, and all our efforts, we would sin and we would ask for forgiveness and we'd be forgiven again because that's what Christ came to do, so that our sins would be forgiven. But we are not going to be perfect. We are going to be faithful. We will come off the path and then we will, by God's grace, come back on, and that will be the way we go. We will fall at times, but by faith, we will be raised again to continue on that straight path. That is the life we have to live. Our treasures, do not store up your treasures on earth, where moth and rust consume and where thieves break in and steal. These things are temporary. Our store must be in heaven. Store up our treasures, God, where God, so that God will be able to call us to his presence. God literally has our salvation, our place in heaven, waiting for us, each of us, literally waiting for us. And 1 Peter chapter 1 reminds us that this, our, you know, that place for us is virtually God has our salvation stored up for us, waiting for when that time comes. Those who have been faithful. And so as we say farewell to our brother this morning, our hope is in that life that is to come for him. And we pray for that faith and courage and steadfastness that will enable us, you and I, to walk that straight path that leads to eternal life. We might not be distracted by the things of this world, but our treasures will not be on earthly things that moth can destroy and thieves can take away. Our treasures must be where our hearts, our treasures must be where that true life, that eternal life is. Jesus says, I go to prepare a place for you. And that is our whole goal, the reason for our being. May we, as we come today, saddened, be assured that God is with us and God is going to give us that comfort. We only need to turn to him. And yes, we turn to him for consolation. And our consolation is not all that we need at this time. We need God's help and strength to walk that straight path. need that faith and courage which comes from him. So may we be able to navigate this world. It's like a very dangerous journey. There are all kinds of ways and means that the evil one will seek to pull us off, you know, divert us from that straight and narrow. So we must be alert. We must be faithful. With our eyes fixed on the goal, we wouldn't be pulled away by the transient pleasures and pleasures of this world. So, eternal rest, we pray, Lord, grant to our brother Edward, that light perpetual shine upon him. Father, we pray that you will be with us as we seek to follow in that way that you've laid out before us through your Son, Jesus Christ, that way that leads to the fullness of eternal life. The Lord be with you. We stand for the Apostles' Creed and our prayers.
Let us with confidence and hope confess the faith into which we were baptized as we all say together, I believe in God the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son of our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and was born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under the Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of sins, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
Amen.
Our prayers continue. And after each petition, your reply will be, Hear us, Lord. After each petition, you will reply, Hear us, Lord. Almighty God, you have knit your chosen people together in one communion, in the mystical body of your Son, Jesus Christ, O Lord. Give to your whole church in heaven and on earth your light and your peace.
Hear us, Lord.
May all who have been baptized into Christ's death and resurrection die to sin, and rise to newness of life. And may we with him pass through the grave and gate of death to our joyful resurrection. Hear us, Lord. Grant us who are still in our pilgrimage and who walk as yet by faith that your Holy Spirit may lead us in holiness and righteousness all our days.
Hear us, Lord.
Grant to your faithful people pardon and peace, that we may be cleansed from all our sins and serve you with a quiet mind.
Hear us, Lord.
Grant to all who mourn a sure confidence in your love and care, that casting all their sorrows on you, they may know the consolation of your love.
Hear us, Lord.
Give courage and faith to those who are bereaved, that they may have strength to meet the days ahead in the comfort of a holy and certain hope, under the joyful expectation of eternal life with those they love.
Hear us, Lord.
Lord Jesus Christ, we commend to you our brother Edward, who was reborn by water and the Spirit in holy baptism. Grant that Edward's death may recall to us your victory over death and be an occasion for us to renew our trust in your Father's love. Give us, we pray, the faith to follow where you have led the way, and where you live and reign with the Father and the Holy Spirit to the ages of ages. Amen.
So we continue with the hymn, All I Ask of You. And during the singing of that hymn, a collection will be taken.
Father in one heart, and for me, that's just the way it is. All I ask of you is forever to remember me as loving you.
As we make our way through all the joys and pain, can we sense a younger true ourselves? All I ask of you is forever to remember me as loving you. Someone will be calling you to live there for a while. Can you hear their cry from deep within? All I ask of you is forever to remember me as loving you. Laughter, joy, and presence, the only gifts you are of your time, I'd like to be with you. All I ask of you is forever to remember me as loving you. Persons come into the fibers of our life, and their veils fade and disappear. All I ask of you is forever to remember me as loving you.
Keep the joy of being together in one heart. For me, that's just where it is.
All I ask of you is forever to remember me as loving you.
Give rest, O Christ, to your servant Edward with your saints.
Where sorrow and pain are no more,
neither sighing but life everlasting.
You only are immortal, creator and maker of mankind, and we are mortal, formed of the earth, and to earth shall we return. For so did you ordain when you created me, saying, you are dust, and to dust you shall return. All of us go down to the dust, yet even at the grave we make our song, Alleluia, Alleluia, Alleluia.
Give rest, O Christ, to your servant, Edward, with your saints, where sorrow and pain are no more, neither signs, but life everlasting.
Let us commend our brother Edward to the mercy of God, our Maker and Redeemer. Deliver your servant Edward, O sovereign Lord Christ, from all evil, and set him free from every bond, that he may rest with all your saints in the eternal habitations, where with the Father and the Holy Spirit you live and reign, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
To your hands, O merciful Savior, commend your servant, Edward. Acknowledge, we humbly beseech you, a sheep of your own fold, a lamb of your own flock, a sinner of your own redeeming. Receive him into the arms of your mercy, to the blessed rest of everlasting peace, and into the glorious company of the saints in light.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Now we have the committal.
Everyone the Father gives to me will come to me. I will never turn away anyone who believes in me.
He who raised Jesus from the dead will also give new life to our mortal bodies through his indwelling spirit.
My heart therefore is glad and my spirit rejoices. My body also shall rest in hope.
You will show me the path of life. In your presence there is fullness of joy. And in your right hand are pleasures forevermore.
I heard a voice from heaven saying, write this, happy are the dead who died in the faith of Christ. Henceforth, says the Spirit, they may rest from their labor, for they take with them the records of their deeds.
Man born of a woman has but a short time to live. Like a flower, he blossoms and then withers. Like a shadow, he flees and never stays.
In the midst of life, we are in debt. To whom can we turn for help but you, Lord, who are justly angered by our sin?
Lord God, holy and mighty, holy and immortal, holy and most merciful Savior, deliver us from the bitter pains of eternal death. You know the secrets of our hearts. In your mercy, hear our prayer, forgive us our sins, and at our last hour, let us not fall away from you.
And now, in the sure and certain hope of resurrection for Lord Jesus Christ, we commend to Almighty God our brother Edward, and we commit his body to the ground, to the elements, earth to earth, ashes to ashes, and dust to dust. We beseech you, Lord, in your infinite goodness, to give us all grace to live in your dear love and to die in your favor, that when your well-beloved Son shall come again in judgment, both our brother Edward and we ourselves may be found acceptable in your sight. Grant this for the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Continue in prayer. The Lord be with you.
And also with you. Let us pray. Almighty God, with whom still lives the spirit of those who died in the Lord, and with whom the souls of the faithful are in the joy and felicity, we give you heartfelt thanks for those good examples of all your servants who have finished their course in faith. Now find rest and refreshment. May we, with all who have died in the true faith of your holy name, have perfect fulfillment and bliss in your eternal and everlasting glory. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Merciful God, Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who is the resurrection and the life, raise us, we humbly pray, from the death of sin to the life of righteousness, that when we depart this life, we may rest in him, and at the resurrection, receive the blessing which your well-beloved Son shall then pronounce. Come, you blessed of my Father, receive the kingdom prepared for you from the beginning of the world. Grant this, O merciful Father, through Jesus Christ, our mediator and redeemer.
Grant, O Lord, to all who are bereaved the spirit of faith and courage,
that they may have strength to meet the days to come with steadfastness and patience, not sorrowing as those without hope, but in thankful remembrance of your great goodness and in the joyful expectations of eternal life with those they love. And this we ask in the name of Jesus Christ, O Lord.
Amen. Rest eternal grant unto Edward, O Lord.
Let light perpetual shine upon him.
May he and all the faithful departed through the mercy of God rest in peace.
Amen.
And may the Lord bless him and keep him. The Lord make his face to shine upon him and be gracious to him. May the Lord lift up the light of his countenance upon him and give him peace. Hallelujah. Christ is risen.
Lord is risen indeed. Hallelujah.
Service, the life of our brother Edward Yeates is ended. Let us now go forth in the name of Christ. Thanks be to God. Our recessional hymn, as we accompany the body out of the church, the battle hymn of the Republic, printed in the bulletin.
I've seen the glory of the coming of the Lord. He is trampling out the vintage where the grapes of wrath is stored. He has loosed the fateful lightning of his terrible swift sword. His truth is marching on. Glory, glory, hallelujah. Glory, glory, hallelujah. Glory, glory, hallelujah. His truth is marching on. I have seen him in the watchfires of 100 circling camps. They have built him an altar in the evening dews and damp. I can read his righteous sentence by the dim and flaring lamps. His days marching on. Glory, glory, hallelujah. Glory, glory, hallelujah. Glory, glory, hallelujah. His truth is marching on. I have read a fiery gospel written burnished shores of steel. As ye deal with my contempt, so with you my grace shall deal. Let the hero born of woman crush the serpent with his head, since God is marching on. Glory, glory, hallelujah. His truth is marching on. He has sounded for the trumpet that shall never call retreat. He is sifting out the hearts of men before his judgment seat. Oh, be swift, my soul, to answer him, to jubilate my feet. Oh, God is marching on. Glory, glory, hallelujah. Glory, glory, hallelujah. Glory, glory, hallelujah. His truth is marching on. In the beauty of the lilies, Christ was born across the sea, with a glory in his bosom that transfigures you and me.
As he died to make men holy, let us live to make him free. As God is marching on. Glory, glory, hallelujah. Glory, glory, hallelujah. Glory, glory, hallelujah. His truth is marching on. He is coming like the glory of the morning on the wave. He is wisdom to the mighty. He is honor to the brave. So the world shall be his footstool and the soul from his slave. Our God is marching on. Glory, glory, hallelujah, hallelujah. Glory, glory, hallelujah. Glory, glory, hallelujah, hallelujah. The truth is marching on.